Welcome back, viewers. I'm your host, Ray Bellows. Today, we have the opportunity to talk with Annie Griffiths. She's a photographer for the National Geographic Society, and she travels the world to places such as Africa, Australia, the Middle East, and North and South America. The photos you'll see throughout the interview were all taken by Annie. Sometimes her work takes her to dangerous places like on top of mountains, under the water, or in jungles, but she says her experiences in places where there are wars going on are more frightening than any wild animals or faraway places. Welcome to the show, Annie.
Thank you, Ray. I'm glad to be here.
Now, you travel a lot. What's your favorite part of the world?
Well, I love Southern Africa. I like the energy of the people and the wildlife. I also love the Galapagos Islands and Mexico. You know, actually, I love so many places that it's hard to choose a favorite.
I can understand that. And why do you like to travel and explore the world so much?
Oh, I love to travel because it allows me to learn about different cultures and, you know, different views of the world. I spend most of my time with ordinary people, and I get to experience how people in different places live their lives. I also love taking pictures of wildlife and landscapes.
Well, your job really is an adventure. My job keeps me sitting in this room day after day. Now, I've read that you've traveled with your children. Why did you take them with you?
Oh, I took my children along on my travels for many reasons. My assignments were often 2 or 3 months long, and I couldn't bear to be away from them for so long. Also, I wanted them to be able to see the world themselves. They have become great travelers and have a great perspective now on the world.
What was their favorite place?
My children loved the Middle East. They had so much fun being part of the Bedouin community there. They rode camels and donkeys and learned to milk goats. They also loved Australia because they got to go to the beach almost every day.
Those do sound like wonderful experiences. But how do you communicate with people in so many places? Say, if you don't speak the language, for example, how do you make friends?
I think the key is to get over my own shyness. I start, you know, by smiling and talking to people. Even if I don't know the local language, I'll gesture or smile and be a little silly so that people feel more relaxed around me.
And that helps you to get your amazing pictures, I'm sure. So, what advice do you have for someone who wants to become a photographer? Do they need any special skills?
I actually think the most important thing a photographer needs is curiosity. You got to wake up every morning wanting to experience something new or learn more about something familiar. It's also important to love being creative and to enjoy seeing things in new ways.
That makes sense. Viewers, does that sound like you? Could you be a photographer? Okay, one last question, Annie. What's your favorite photo and what's the story behind it?
My favorite photo is of a man standing on top of Victoria Falls in Zambia. The light is so beautiful, and it brings back memories of an unforgettable day at one of the most amazing places on Earth.
That is a beautiful photo. It's one of my favorites, too. Well, that's all the time we have. Thanks very much for being here today, Annie.
No problem. Nice talking to you, Ray.